Hi, this is The Hobbyist. Thank you for being here. Today I'm going to be unboxing and trying out this Daniel Smith Extra Fine Watercolors. So this is their 24 color hand poured watercolor half pan set in a metal box, and it also comes with free metal box and 24 empty half pans. Daniel Smith brand is known for their finest handcrafted paints. And this one is hand-poured. All of their pans actually are hand-poured, and they use exact formula for both tube and hand-poured pan colors. By the way, this video is not sponsored, but if you want to check this set out or purchase one for yourself, I will put the links in the description below. Okay, so let's open this. Ta-da! Inside the box are two individual boxes. One is the paint, and let's open this free metal box first, the bonus one. I honestly think that this is a brilliant marketing strategy for the Daniel Smith company, because by giving bonus or free metal box and 24 empty half pans, you're actually encouraging people to buy more of your products. It has the finger hoop at the back, and I love the matte feeling of the paint. And inside you have the foldable palettes and the 24 empty half pans that you can also lift. I believe this is like an aluminum metal, the ones inside. Feels sturdy, like it won't break unless it will rust in the future, but I really like the feeling of the paint, matte outside and enamel white inside. Right, so let's set it aside and open why we are here for this 24 hand-poured watercolor half-pan set in a metal box. When I was doing my research about premium quality watercolors, Daniel Smith brand always comes up. And this is made in the US, made in Seattle. And this, since then, has always been in my artist's wish list at the top. And I know I've mentioned before that Winsor & Newton Field Sketchbox is in my wish list, but I do have a lot of items in my art wish list. So anyway, I'm just so happy that I found a shop here that's selling Daniel Smith, and here it is. Just exactly like the free metal box, it has the Daniel Smith logo, and it has the metal casing with matte black paint outside and white enamel paint on the inside. So this one feels like powdery. There's a powder substance. I feel like it must be from the pigment. Inside there is a plastic acetate that has the sample printed swatches of the colors. It also has the information, the name, the light fast rating, staining, transparency, granulation, and the pigment code as well, which is great for reference, but we'll still do the swatch later, the swatches later, so that I could find out for myself how the pigments or how the colors behave. I like the selection of the colors, so it's like warm and cool colors, and also neutral. And these are the 24 half pans. They have individual casing, and you can lift it, lift this so you can see it better. I like that it's not individually wrapped. Number one, because that's more environmentally friendly, lesser plastic, lesser wrapper. But although I personally love the sound ASMR when I'm unwrapping individual half pans, just like candies. But this one, it also has like tiny powder. I'm not really sure if this is pigment or if it's rust from the casing. So that's just one thing that I'm always worried about when it comes to metal casing. They easily rust, but I'm not sure. It feels like it's like powdery pigment. Maybe it's from the pigment. I suggest writing down the names of the colors and the side of the individual half bands because it doesn't have it, just in case it will fall off. Now let's do the swatches. In this set, 19 colors are actually just using single pigment, which is good because it means that they are pure. And the rest, like Quinacridone Gold, Permanent Alizarin Crimson, Sap Green, Undersea Green, and James Gray, they are using more than one pigment. Like James Gray is a mixture of ultramarine blue and burnt sienna, but there is no fugitive color in any of them, which is great. For this test, I'm painting a scene from Minalungaw National Park, which is in my hometown, La Vaisija, Philippines. Loving the experience on this one. The colors are vibrant and they're just easy to use and easy to manipulate. Okie dokie, what I like about this, what's good, in fact, what I love about this is that, number one, the easy activation and reactivation. So I did not have to use a lot of water if I just need a little bit, or, you know, it's just easy to use if I want to intensify the colors. So I find it very, very pleasant, the experience of wetting the paint and using it and reactivating it even when it's already on the paper. And number two, the creaminess. I feel the difference between, up to this point, I have only been using student grade watercolors, and I never really understand it when I watch videos and they try to compare student grade and artist or premium grade. But there is really the difference. I think it has something to do with the premium ingredients that they put in their color. So if it's really pure pigment, you can really feel the smoothness, you can see it in the dispersion, the blending, and it's just really a pleasant experience. Another thing that I like is the color selection. So there are 19 warm colors here and only 6, but I love the yellow, reds, the green, and the blues in the palette because you can use it for any type of watercolor subject. So landscape, flowers, still life, animals, even portrait, you can create skin colors with this one. And color selection for me is great. And when it comes to light fastness, 23 is graded excellent, and 1 is, I think, if I'm not mistaken, that is the Hansa yellow light, is rated very good. So I mean excellent and very good. That's very light fast, and that is what makes, I guess, the difference between premium or artist grade versus the student grade ones. Because this paint you can use for any watercolor painting that you like to last for so many years, or even for commission paints or commission projects. And also, I love the transparency. So transparency, 14 colors are semi-transparent, 9 are transparent, and only 1 is actually rated opaque, which is the Indian red. But even so, in our test, I did not see that it's really that opaque. So if you can see here, they are very much transparent or semi-transparent, which is actually great. And also, when it comes to staining, around 22 colors are rated non-staining to medium staining, But they are very liftable. So as you can see in my test, I dried it up and then I tried to lift it. Even those that are actually rated like high staining, which are those colors, the Halo Blue and the Halo Green. So here they are liftable, and that is also good. And also, when it comes to texture, Daniel Smith is the king of granulation, as they say. And in this set, 15 is rated like that they are actually granulating, and 15 over 24 colors. And for me, that is actually good because I like texture in my paintings. For some, they might not like it, but again, I think granulation is just based on what you prefer when it comes to your subject or the kind of painting that you like. So I can't really say anything bad about it. These colors are vibrant. I think everything that you need in a paint is right here in Daniel Smith. And because this is kind of like a travel set in a half pans and 24 colors, I believe they also have they're also selling the 12 ones and tubes. This one I like because you can change the half pans. If you're traveling and you have a favorite color, you can just like change it. But if there's one or two things that may be not so good, number one, it's not really cheap. I got this on sale, but I guess when it comes to watercolor, any type of materials, you really get what you pay for. So for its price compared to its quality, I think like it's reasonable. And another thing, that if there is something, I think it would be the box, because I feel that even though inside of it is painted like with enamel, there are certain parts that I feel long term would start to rust, like this and the hinge and underneath. So over here and here as well. But that doesn't have anything to do with the quality of the paint. It's just like the casing. So, all right. Let me get my other swatches from my previous videos for my own personal ranking. Okay. So, right. I think I have a new number one, and this is the Daniel Smith Extra Fine Watercolors. There's a lot of pros, actually. I'm really struggling to find something that is not good about it, and which means that everything goes lower in my rank. So number one will be Daniel Smith. Second would be the Winsor & Newton Cotman Watercolors Field Box. This is 12 half pans. What I love about this is the design of the case, I mean, for travelers. Then my third would be Van Gogh. Light Fast as well. This two, rated Light Fast. Fourth would be Mumio, for creaminess, smoothness, dispersion, right? But this comes next after Van Gogh, because they don't actually provide like a light fast rating for this. And then my fifth one would be Koi Sakura. Okay, I love the color selection as well, 24 colors. Also, no light fast rating. but for its price, can't really ask for more. I love this. I always bring this in traveling. And the last one, number 6, would be Museo Watercolor Sketchers Pocket Box by Street Art Material. So this one, it has no pigment information, also no, it lacks the information. But again, this is the cheapest among all the student grades. So, right, this is student grade, and this is my first artist grade or professional grade, premium grade, however you want to name it, watercolor set. Okay. So in the future I'll be reviewing something that just came in as well this weekend, and I believe this is rated premium grade, and this is, I've heard a lot of things about this, and this is the White Knights St. Petersburg Extra Fine Artist Watercolors. So we'll see if this one will be our new number one. Don't know. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching.